Okay, I'm down here on the coast of California, and tonight we're going to be doing some fluoro diving, basically looking at some of the critters in the intertidal zone with a blue flashlight and a yellow filter. And this brings out the fluorescence like you wouldn't believe. So let's have a look. Here's the fluorescence with the filter on it, and you can see how these guys come alive. I take away the yellow filter, and it's pretty much the blue light illuminating this whole area. What a difference. It's amazing what you can see out here.
In living organisms, we call fluorescence biofluorescence. And all that's happening is that organisms absorb radiation or light at a certain wavelength and then re-emit it at another wavelength.
Well, let's just follow the yellow brick road here. Oh my goodness. And just keep going on and on and on. I'm gonna illuminate further forward. This is fantastic. So not right on. Scale.
It's pretty common in the marine environment, and a lot of different organisms throughout the tree of life, you might say, have this ability. Not all of them. We see it also in minerals to a certain extent, and that's a fluorescence, where minerals emit visible light when they're exposed to ultraviolet light. So what we've done here is take a dark blue light, which borders into the ultraviolet, and often people use some kind of a black light, which has a lot of ultraviolet radiation. Well, that surface of the organism absorbs that light, and if you put a filter in front of you, you'll see the wavelength at longer wavelengths, or you'll see the light at longer wavelengths emitted in that color. So, for example, we put a yellow filter in front of these organisms that are illuminated, and now we see all the fluorescence in the yellow part of the spectrum that come alive. You could probably do this with a red filter or some other filter, and other colors will come alive to you or be visible. A lot of marine organisms use this biofluorescent property to enable them to ward off predators or possibly to look for other mates. It's a form of communication. It might be even in a mating ritual. So there's still a lot of mechanisms or reasons for having this ability that scientists are still exploring. But it's a fascinating area. So typically these organisms fluoresce when they're in the water, and naturally we're getting mostly blue light and it spills over into ultraviolet. And they absorb this light at that high frequency, and they use some of that energy to survive for energy themselves, just like photosynthesis requires some sunlight energy. Then they re-emit some of that remaining energy down into a lower frequency, so red or green or even yellow. This is done at a cellular level down the chromatophores. We see the chromatophores in camouflage, but these are a different variety of chromatophores. Now, if we go even further at an atomic level, what's happening is that radiation comes in, and that excites an electron in an atom, and it jumps to a higher orbital. And almost immediately, then, it's going to come back down to where it's stable at a lower orbital, or shell, in its orbit around the nucleus. And in that process of dropping back down, it emits a photon at a different wavelength. Finally, we've been talking about fluorescence, which is a short-term emission of radiation, but there is also phosphorescence, which takes a longer time to set up. This is a different process, and this is also different from bioluminescence, where there's a chemical reaction that goes on, and this can be caused by bacteria interacting with cells or some kind of chemistry or electrical motion or something else. These are all different processes.